So how does this even happen? A team burdened with a history of financial irregularities, whose last taste of glory was 21 years ago. A team from a forgotten region. They say Molise non esiste, but here's a team emboldened by new ownership on the cusp of a historic promotion. A true underdog. This is the story of Campobasso, a team in the fourth tier of Italian football with grand intentions and lofty dreams.
I didn't even know where Molise was. You know, and my grandparents came from, you know, 40 minutes away from Campobasso.
When they said Molise non esiste, was the best advertising for Molise, because people started searching about where is this Molise. Some of the people in Italy don't know the Molise is a region of Italy.
We say that the Molise region actually doesn't exist. But I think that Molise exists, and that is very important, because this region has a very important and amazing history.
My name is Marco Messina, and my love of the beautiful game started at a young age. That love and passion led me to IFTV, a community dedicated to the fans of Italian football all around the world. I've been fortunate enough to interview some of the biggest names in football and some of my idols. But learning about Campobasso, a team I hadn't even heard of before, from a region I didn't even know existed, has been a special experience.
Speaking of the people from the region, obviously football is such an important thing for all of us.
Yeah, yeah.
How important do you think the Campobasso, the team, the football club, is to the region?
That's very important. I mean, people are very tied to their region, and they get behind to support everything that is local.
I had watched the videos of Campobasso beating Juventus in front of 40,000 people, which is incredible, by the way, because it's a 25,000-seat stadium, but they somehow packed 40,000 in when they played Juventus.
It was packed. The stadium was completely packed. The fans of Juventus were crying in my village because they were, I mean, really passionate. They couldn't believe they lost with Campobasso.
C'è lo scatto di Goretti. Eccolo qui. A destra, il cross è buono. Intervento della difesa, palla Ugolotti.
It was incredible to see the proud of the people from Molise of having Campobasso there. It was like having the town there. So I think it's important. It's something that will bring people together.
Campobasso in vantaggio per 1-0 sulla Juve al 38esimo.
When I met Matt, I saw a hungry entrepreneur that wanted the best for Campobasso. Connecting over our Italian heritage and love for calcio, I realized that Matt was an example where good guys do actually finish first. So Matt, how did we get here? How did we get to owning a team?
You know, I grew up so close with my grandparents. My grandparents, especially my grandfather, you know, just hardworking immigrant, you know, came here from Italy in the 1950s. He actually immigrated to North 6th Avenue right outside of the Bronx in Mount Vernon, New York. And we named our company North 6th Agency, now it's North 6th Group. After the street they emigrated to. And he was a diehard soccer fan. Some of the greatest memories I have of my childhood were sitting on his lap. I could still smell the espresso in my grandmother's kitchen. Sunday mornings, you know, watching Juventus, watching Inter, watching Milan in the 90s. And that was one thing I wanted to do, was I wanted to go out and buy a football club. We didn't just choose any club. We chose a club from, you know, central southern Italy, within, you know, a 100-kilometer radius of where my grandparents immigrated from. That's really what I was looking to. Those were the clubs I was looking to invest in. And we wanted to buy more than just a football club. Like I said, we wanted to buy a club that really could represent, could serve as a platform to represent immigrants and expats and underdogs, people who have struggled and, you know, who started out without all of the resources and without all of the advantages that so many other people had. And that's what led us to Campobasso.
They say we have a couple of teams in my mind. We gotta choose the good one. So right away, he told me about the Campobasso. And I told you, Marco, I follow lover right away. And I said, Nicole, I want you to be with me. I want you to be my right-hand man. You gotta be with me. And anything I do, I told Matt, I said, for soccer, I do anything, especially for you. I do anything for you. That's why we're on this point now.
How'd you feel when he told you that?
I was really excited, because this is what I do all my life. I love soccer.
Nicola has such an incredible story, because he was a great football player himself, and he was grew up in Italy and actually was in the youth system of Inter Milan. I think Giacinto Facchetti was the coach, who's a legendary Italian football player. And Nicola lost his father at a young age and had to take on tremendous responsibility as a man to look after his family and had to basically leave behind all of his football career and dreams.
When my father passed away, he was the right move to leave soccer for a few, probably I can say few months to stay with my mother, to stay with my family. And then after that, I was still young, I was still 14, 15 years old. So I think I was, you know, my father, he looked down for me what I'm doing. I love soccer, so that's why I never want to step down until today.
And now you have this opportunity with Campobasso.
So the Campobasso investment for me is a beautiful investment too, because it gives him an opportunity to finally, you know, at age 45 or whatever, it gives him an opportunity to finally come back and relive his and live his dream, the dream that he set out to accomplish when he was a child, which was to make a living in professional football.
They're good people. They deserve the world. That's why me and Matt, we want to bring Campobasso where they belong, where these people belong.
Why do they belong? Why do they deserve it?
I used to have a Stadio Romagnoli, a stadio now. We used to be Juventus. They used to be Lazio. Now we play, we don't want to say any name. It's not right to say no names. We play in the league where we don't belong. We want a Juventus to come to us. We want a Fiorentina to come to with us.
If you look back at this club's history, it was founded in 1919. They went through so many bankruptcies and failed, you know, ownership and leadership decisions over the course of the past century. The reality is, whenever this club has been managed properly, the fan base has never let them down.
Consulente esterno del Campobasso, Aliberti, perentorio nell'ultima uscita a mezzo stampa. O si trovano 200.000 euro nel giro di due settimane, oppure la dura realtà sarà portare i libri in tribunale. Parole chiare ed inequivocabili, ma che soprattutto...
So Campobasso, which we've learned now, has suffered under different ownerships so many financial irregularities. How do you see that going forward? Do you think that will could continue for Italian football?
No, I think that there is this kind of risk, but I think that new owners can change this mind. This is the history, the financial history of the Italian football.
What I really admire what Matt did is you see a lot of American businessmen and owners investing in soccer teams that are already well capitalized and wealthy in northern region of Italy. And the fact that Matt decided to invest in a small region like Molise and help southern Italy, I think is a bold move. And I think that is really going to pay off for him.
We chose Campobasso over other teams from Champions Leagues. We talk about Lugano in Switzerland, or we talk about Regina in Serie B, or we talk about Palermo in Serie C right now. And he chose Campobasso. For me, it's the top. Matteo is the top.
What struck me of Matt, that he doesn't like to talk about power, to talk about money, to talk about how important he is. He prefers to talk about the future.
I don't want to put a ceiling on this, because I believe that there's great people in this project, and I believe with great people you can accomplish amazing things, unprecedented things. And the club itself has been to Serie B before. They were, you know, a few points away from reaching Serie A, and I see no reason why in the long term we can't do that again and then aspire to do a lot more than that.
You're someone that keeps looking to the future while also remembering your past. What do you think your grandfather would make of all this?
If he was here today, I hope he would say that it was worth it. It was worth him, you know, sacrificing his family and the language and the culture to come to this country, because his grandson, you know, gave back in the right way. That's it.